station.
Hello again, Paul Barnes for Video Classics. This cassette features Canadian Pacific locomotive number 1201 on one of her most popular annual excursions from Ottawa to Pembroke, Ontario. So let's get on board and take a ride on the Autumn Valley Express.
Thank you.
Duncan. Good morning.
Our train leaves from the National Museum of Science and Technology.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Ross Carruthers. I'll be your car host for the trip today. We hope you do have a pleasant trip up to Pembroke with us. Those of you who were here last year know we're off to a better start with the weather anyway. We could have swum last year up there. It was that wet. If you have any questions en route about the train, the features around us, the locomotive or the route we're on, please feel free to ask them and I'll attempt to answer your questions. If I can't answer it, I'll either make up an answer or I'll find out for you. There is toilet facilities in this coach, but it won't be opened up until we're underway, which means very shortly. There's also a snack bar, two cars forward, and one at the very front of the train, which also sells souvenirs as well. So have a pleasant trip. Any questions, any problems, please ask me. Thank you.
We over here.
The Ottawa River separates the provinces of Ontario and Quebec. On today's trip to Pembroke, over CN's Beechburg sub, we begin in Ontario, then cross the river into Quebec. Later, we cross the river again, returning to Ontario.
Yeah.
We are now in Quebec and nearing the location of today's first run past at Norway Bay.
Thank you.
We're now back in Ontario and approaching Beechburg, where the 1201 will do a double run past.
Okay. I'm just going to be here for a
while. No, come here.
You got a hot one?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Careful.
As the train pulls into Pembroke, we'll make our way back to the souvenir counter.
Yeah.
After a little switching, number 1201 heads to Canadian National's Loxley subdivision, where it will be wide for the return trip. Locomotive number 1201 was built by the Canadian Pacific Railway at its Angus shops in Montreal in June of 1944. The engine is one of 102 G5 class light Pacifics, acquired near the end of World War II, to replace its aging fleet of branch line and secondary mainline locomotives. Numbers 1200 and 1201 were the prototypes for the class, and 1201 was the last locomotive completely built at the Angus shops. In revenue service, the engine ran for many years between Montreal and Perth on the Perth Local, and later to North Bay and Sault Ste. Marie, Ontario, and Farnham, Quebec. She was retired in 1960, and the museum acquired her in 1966. She was restored, converted to burn oil, and returned to excursion service in 1976. While the engine's being serviced, we'll finally have time for a bite to eat. After the engine is serviced, all of the people who helped make this trip a success will meet at the front of the locomotive for a group photograph.
Yeah.
Our last run past of the day was here at Finchley, Ontario.
Thank you.
Forrester's Falls, we pull onto a siding to let a CN freight pass. Once again, the train begins to slow down to cross the Ottawa River. Near Bristol, Quebec, we make our last stop of the day to take on water. As the sun sets, we cross the Ottawa River for the fourth and last time today, returning to the province of Ontario. Thank you. Now we'll turn back the clock one day and visit the museum Saturday afternoon as 1201 is prepared for her Sunday excursion. But first, we'll check out number 6200 on display outside the museum.
Once she's hot, she's hot.
After taking a look around here inside the shop, we'll return to the 1201's cab as the Bytown Railway Society's Duncan Dufresne oversees the firing up of the locomotive. Again?
Well, we light her on compressed air, and now we're switching over from compressed air to steam.
Oh.
Because we have no steam. You have to have something to do your atomizing and give you your blower. So we use shop air. But once you get steam on her to the extent where she'll go on her own, then you have to get rid of the air and get on steam. That's what we're doing now. It's okay.
This is one of these times you need about 8 arms, right? So you can do all sorts of things at once.
Hit her.
Oh, what now?
Hit her. There you go. Perfect.
Beauty!
Yeah, yeah.
100 RPM.
And how much pressure do you need to drive it?
Well, if you're not running any more laps than we are right now, you don't need much. Like, we're only with 80 pounds of steam there right at the moment. But if you had the headlight on, that wouldn't be enough to, because there's 250 watts in that bulb. These little 15-watt bulbs, and there's just two of those and a 60 burning at the moment. So with that small amount of draw, you'll spin right up and blow the steam.
Earlier in the day on Saturday, we decided to pay a visit to the Ottawa Railroad Station. The station displays an impressive collection of model locomotives, including, of course, the 1201.
Hello again. I hope you enjoyed the tape. Please stay tuned for previews of our other videos. But first, some special thank yous to the people and organizations who helped make this trip and video possible.
To end the tape, we'll see some shots taken with our original video camera. The picture quality and color are not as good as on our new high-resolution cameras, but we hope you'll enjoy this little bonus anyway.
Yeah.
Now, please stay tuned for previews of our other videos.